This is a harmless manifestation of joy, and has been prescribed by the great physician in Psalm 30 verse 1. Weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes
you. And you're saying, that sounds nice, Mandisa, but how do I know that this valley of the shadow of death that I'm currently in right now is going to result in me being stronger when I come out of it? Let me tell you how I know. Because it is written in the Word of God. Amen? Let me tell you. 1 Peter 5:10. It says that the God of all grace, after you have suffered a little while, will himself restore you and make you strong and firm and steadfast. And let me tell you, when Peter was writing that, he was writing it to those who call themselves by the name of Jesus. Those who say that I am a follower of Jesus Christ. And so that means that it is a promise for each and every one of you. And can I go so far as to say this? That I know that sometimes we walk through things that we feel like it's going to take us out. I'm a living witness of that. But here's what I also know, is that if you're still here on earth, if there's still breath in your body, then God has given you everything you need in order to make it that very next step. And here's what I love about our Father, is that he doesn't just end with removing a thorn out of our flesh. I love knowing that our God is the God of true redemption. And true redemption is not just when you can say that you made it over that mountain that you were climbing. True redemption is when you come back and you make the enemy sorry that he ever messed with you in the first place. That is true redemption. With that thing that feels like it's going to take you out, that addiction, that diagnosis where the doctors say they don't know what to do, that problem with your marriage, that kid in school that is messing with you and won't seem to let up. True redemption, which is what our Father specializes in, is when God takes that very thing that you don't know if you can make it out. And when you come out of the other side, he makes it your ministry. When he takes a test and makes it your testimony. Amen? There are some people here tonight. You need to be reminded. You got to hold on just a little bit longer. The pain ain't going to last forever. And when you come out of it, you're going to come out of it better. You're going to be redeemed. You're going to have a story that's going to pull somebody else out of the pit that you're currently in. And here's what God says to us. You don't wait until the battle's over. You shout right now. You worship God. When we can worship God in the middle of our suffering, that is when we know that we are true followers of Christ. See, we don't worship God because our circumstances are good. We worship God because he is good. And his mercy endures forever. So Father, we bless you here tonight. We lift up your name, God, because you're worthy of it. You are holy, and you are faithful, and we can trust you. We pray for grace to trust you more. Father, as we're walking this out, we lift up your name, because you are good.
I can never say enough to thank you.
overcomer.